Hello, welcome back. Today's lesson, we're going to be looking at the Harry Styles track, Sign of the Times. It's a real great one for beginners, and also if you like the track as well, just have a go at it. It's a good one to do. There's a few little challenges in there. There's a bar chord in the middle eight section, which we'll look at a little bit later. But yeah, just get your teeth stuck into this one, see if you can learn it over the weekend, a little bit of a challenge for you. Okay, so there's five chords in this song. We've got F, D minor, C, C7, and B flat as well, the bar chord that comes up later on in the song. So if we do the intro section first, we're going to start with an F major chord. This is an F major with a partial bar at the top with your first finger just across the B and the E strings, fret number one. And then you want your second finger, second fret of the G string, fret number two. And then my third finger, fret number three on the D string. What I'll do is I'll play through the intro section for you with the strumming pattern. And then I'll break it down, break down the chords so that you can visually see the chords as well that come up on screen. Okay, so here we go. There's F to begin with, so it's... So as you can see, this is a great one for beginners because it's all down strumming, so you don't really have to think too much about the right hand. You're going to think more about the left hand and the positions that you're doing with your fingers with the chord changes. Just a few tips as well as we go along the way. A great thing to be able to do is to try and spot the difference between one chord and the next chord and the next chord in the bar as it comes along, because sometimes they'll share notes and you can get away with not moving, keeping a finger down and just moving the other fingers, and it just speeds things up a little bit, and it stops a little lag in between the bars. So, as I said, first chord is F major, which I explained was third finger, third fret of the D string, second finger, second fret of the G string, and your first finger, you've got a little mini bar at the top here on B string and the E string, fret number one. So that's your first chord. You're gonna do four strums in the bar, so four down strums. Okay, that's your first one. Second chord is a D minor. So again, as I said, this is where you're looking out for these similarities. In the D minor and, sorry, the F and the D minor chords, the second finger stays the same, same location. You just move down your third finger and bring down your first finger there. Okay? So just to make that quicker for you, I'm doing that, and it'll just speed things up on in terms of your chord changes. Okay, so next chord, D minor. We're gonna do four down strums again on this one. To C. No similarities in this chord, we have to move our fingers and change them. We change them up to third finger, third fret of the A string, second finger, second fret of the D string, and then the first finger, first fret of the B string. And then we strum that again. We'll do this one eight times now, so two bars of four. So we're going to go one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Okay, so that's your introduction. That just happens one cycle. So I'll play that through. Good thing is, if you know that section, the verse is exactly the same, but it happens two cycles. So I'll play that how that should sound, but the chords are exactly the same, F, D minor, and C for two bars. So it goes like this. That then leads us onto the pre-chorus, which again, very, very similar. It does F, D minor, C, and on the first cycle, it does C7 on the end. So I'll tell you what that chord is there. So if we run it through, we've got F, D minor, one bar of C now, and then one bar of C7, where I just add my little finger to the C chord. Again, so this is gonna make things quicker if you can sort of see the similarities. So we put a little finger down on the third fret of the G string, and I'm going to strum that four times. Now on the second cycle, just to confuse you, it goes back to the C on the end, so you do two bars of C at the end there. So I play the whole pre-chorus for you, it should sound like this. Okay, this leads us now into the chorus section, and the chorus is literally the first part of the first bar of the first line of the pre-chorus, which is the F, D minor, C, and C7, and that happens for two cycles. What I would suggest on the chorus is it can become a little bit samey if you just stay to doing the Dane strums, and it'd be a little bit boring for you. Great for beginners to get your strumming pattern right, but what we're going to do on the chorus is just take it up a little bit and just change the strumming pattern. So keep the same chords, as I said. F, D minor, C, and C7. But this time we're going to strum. We're going to go. So it's still quite a simple pattern. Just going to go down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. I'll say that one again. So it's down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. Okay? So if I play that through your chorus, it goes like this. So another thing to say to you as well is just to, when you're practicing your chords, another thing to quicken up the chord changes is not to be scared of doing like an up strum on the open strings as you change the chord to give you a little bit longer to change. So now and again, you might see me do this. Okay, and because it happens all so quickly, your ear doesn't pick up on the fact that I'm actually just going and changing to the next chord. So you can get away with it, as I said, depending where you are on the bar, if it's an up strum or a down strum, you can get away with just strumming the open strings. It gives you a little bit longer to change to the next chord. And it just gives it some sort of character as well. It gives it some sort of more of rhythm to it. Instead of sounding quite stale and just doing down, 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 stop, down, 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 you can just add that extra open string in there. Cool, so that's your chorus section. There's only one more section to look at. And this is the bit where it becomes a little bit tricky because you've got the bar chord that comes in. So the mid-late section of the song, all exactly the same in the chorus, don't panic. It's the same rhythm as well, so I'm going to go. And this is where it changes. And it goes to B-flat major, so it goes to this. I'm going to repeat that round. F, D minor, C major, B-flat major. Now, there's a couple of ways of doing this B-flat chord. You can do it, it's obviously a bar chord, this is where the tricky bit comes in. So you're going to bar your first finger flat across the five strings, and you want the tip of your first finger to touch the sixth string, so that when you strum, if you accidentally hit the E string, which happened from time to time, it will be muted. So you keep your first finger flat across the five strings there, fret one. Now, there's a couple of ways of doing this. I'll explain all the different varieties of this. So one of them's more of a classical way of doing it, and it's finger two, three, and four on fret 3s of your D, G, and B strings. So the advantage of doing that way is the fact that the first fret on the first string there will ring out, that nice little chimey quality to the top there, will ring out nice and clearly. And that's more of a classical way of doing it. The rocking sort of pop way of doing it is with your third finger barring across the fret 3 at the D, the G, and the B strings, like that. Disadvantage with that one, it sounds great, but the disadvantage is it cuts out the high E string. So it's up to you, and naturally I go to that one anyway. You can do the bar, the second bar you can do with your third finger, or you can do it with your little finger as well, if you're struggling to reach out. Most important thing to say about a bar chord as well is to try and keep your thumb, just drop it down a little bit on the back of the neck, and try to keep it straight on the back of the neck. So it's sort of in line, and it allows you to get your your first finger. So drop the hand down. So you don't keep it all close like this and have your thumb around the top. If you try and do it like that with your thumb at the top, you're going to struggle. You need to drop the thumb down. The hand will open up. There you go. And you want to press down nice and firmly on there and try and get a nice clear bar chord. So. Or. Okay, and just a little variation on that as well, because we did say it was a bit of a beginner's lesson. And I don't want any beginners to get to this point and go, oh, I can't do that. So we're going to give you a power chord to do instead of the B-flat, just a bit of a variation. Have a go at the bar chord if you're really struggling with it and you're just new to your play, and then just ignore the B-flat major bar chord and play a B-flat 5 power chord instead. And that simply is just fret number 1 on the A string. And then that's with your first finger. Then you want your third finger on fret 3 on the D string. And that's absolutely fine if you want to hit those two strings. If you want to net a little bit of a challenge, just add this little finger down as well. It just doubles up on the root note, which is down here on the chord. And you got your little finger on fret 3 as well. And then you can have that power chord there, the full power chord. So. And when you hit that, just aim to hit just the three strings where your fingers are on. Try not to hit any of the other ones, because it will sound horrible. I hope you enjoyed that. See if you can get that down over the weekend. A little challenge for you. And I'll see you in the next lesson.